Hi guys, welcome to Neon Vision, and in today's video I'm gonna be watching the entry of Ukraine, which is Stefania by Kalush Orchestra. First of all, I know that this wasn't the song that won the national selection because it was another song, but the singer of that song had some problems with entering Russia before, so with entering Crimea before, so she had to be disqualified, or I don't know if she had to be disqualified or she withdrew, but she will unfortunately not be able to represent Ukraine, and it will be Kalush Orchestra. So Ukraine last year was my absolute favorite, like Shum was the best song I've ever heard on Eurovision, so I have really high hopes. So last year's entry was the best of all time, I have to say that. I really liked that song, I listened to it on repeat every day for 2 months, I think, and I remember that I was very happy when they came second in a televote and they came fifth in the whole competition, and I was really happy when the results were revealed. So I'm looking forward to this year's entry as well, since I liked last year's entry so much. I'm kind of curious what this year's entry will be like. And since we're talking about Ukraine right now, I think I must mention that I send my best wishes to the Ukrainian people who are suffering right now, who have to live through this whole thing. I just don't understand how can this happen in 2022, and this is really disgusting. So I really send all my best wishes to you guys, because you deserve it. But let's see what this year's entry from Ukraine will be like. So the title is Stefania, which word is really familiar, because Stefania represented Greece last year, so it's kind of funny, but this time it's not the singer, it's the title of the song. So I'm really curious, let's watch it. Well, I think the crowd really likes them. I think it will be another great song. Like, this really has the similar folklore elements like last year, which I always appreciate and I always like. I think this will be a really cool song. And also this language, I really like it a lot. I liked it last year, I like it this year as well. I will always like Ukrainian language. I wasn't expecting any rapping, like guys, this is really epic, I have to say that. So guys, Ukraine is always really good at combining music styles, because this part is kind of hip-hop part, but the beginning was a folk music part, so they're really good at combining these things. Like last year it was electronic music with folk music, and this year it's amazing, I have to say. Back to the epic part, like guys, that vocal. I enjoy it a lot. And again, flute like last year. I love it. I think Ukraine needs to have flute in their song every year. It's a great element. It's the best in the world. I love it. I've noticed something. Is on the right side of the screen, is it the guy who was a band member of Goway? Because I've seen some photos about this band, and I've seen him, and I honestly don't know if it's him because he's in sunglasses, but that might be him. but probably he's on the stage, but I don't really know which one of the guys he is. But I think he's that one with the sunglasses. But he isn't the one who's playing the flute, which is interesting, because last year he was playing the flute. I know that wasn't the flute, that was a soplika, I think that's what it's called. It was a traditional Ukrainian instrument, I think, if I remember correctly. Is she a member of the jury? I actually expected a very similar song like to this from Ukraine, and I got it, and I'm really happy about it. Like, this is really a Ukrainian song. That's what you can expect from Ukraine. Also, the costumes, they are probably traditional Ukrainian ones, which I always appreciate. They look great, and the staging looks great. It's again black and red, like from like Soloway in 2020, which was also one of my favorite songs. Oh, Jamala! This drop is everything I need. Flute part with this beat is I just can't explain it. It's out of this world, just like last year. This can even be my favorite one. I really like it. I really really like it, guys. It's amazing! I love it, guys! And the crowd loves it too! Guys, this is amazing! And Soloway is there, which is also a great song. And I know she was the original winner, but sadly she couldn't represent her country. But this song is the final song of Ukraine, which I absolutely love, guys. As I've already said, it really reminds me of Goey's songs, Soloway and Shum, and probably, as far as I know, one of the Goey members is in this band as well, but I didn't really recognize him. So I can't describe this song with a lot of words, but the most important one is epic. I'm always comparing it to last year's entry, but this is almost as good as Shum, because that was my favorite song of all time, and this is almost my favorite song of all time. I really appreciate this song, and if I had the chance to vote, because I don't have it, I would definitely vote for it 1,000 times. And unfortunately I don't have the chance to vote because I'm in Hungary and we don't participate, so I would really like to vote, but I cannot. Can I say winner alert, just like last year? I think this is my winner. I have to say that this song is my winner so far. I think this will be the first time I give 10 points to a song out of 10, because this song really deserves it. It's out of this world. I can't explain it properly. I absolutely love this song. There won't be any songs like this in the competition, and it's always Ukraine who is really unique every single year. So this honestly took the first place for me. It's absolutely my favorite one so far. But I'm curious, guys, what do you think about this song? Let me know in the comments. And if you like this video, then give it a like and a subscribe. And you can also follow me on Instagram and TikTok as well. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.